What a beautiful day. What a beautiful day. This is Tarantino News. Coming to you live from Universal Headquarters in conjunction with Unity the Movement. And we're here one more time, feeling like you two this morning. It's a beautiful day. And I'm personally feeling like Bono, the lead singer. Because just awake and shaking, rocking, shocking, looking good, feeling good. Ate a banana this morning. So I'm feeling as if I'm freshly produced out of the soil. This is Fruit and Vegetable Week. No intake besides fruits, vegetables, and water. So this is a water-based diet, not a plant-based diet, because most plants and vegetables are well over 90% water. So this will be a water-based diet this week, and definitely will come out on the other side, barring any interference with man, will come out on the other side slim and trim. I have a big brother somewhere out there in the stratosphere. Way back when, there was a wise man, and he told me, he said, what you need to do is get slim and trim like your brother. So it took a while for that to sink in, but it's finally sunken in. And I remember when he told me, the old man told me about getting slim and trim like my brother. My brother had me riding a Navi, that's the old school Lincoln Navigator. And he had me riding a BMW 750. So it does pay to get slim and trim. Because I wasn't bringing in any income, but I was balling. Play on the scene. I'm feeling mean. You know how I go. So I was doing all those things, reaping where I did not sow. So let me make a quick point this morning about people who say you reap what you sow. I spit on that. That's junior high, okay? That's junior high. You're not fully developed yet. So I love, it's like with the old song, it might've been Tretch, but I can't remember now. It might've been Onyx. I just love when somebody bring their whole crew, you know? It's just a bigger something for me to run a hole through. Something like that. But I just love when I hear somebody talking about you reap what you sow. Because they could be, oh, you reap what you sow, you know, 80 years old. That's junior high. You got a ways to go. You ain't developed all the way. Because the true essence of a human being that's filled with purpose is to reap the labors that somebody else left undone. You do understand that most humans in this world, they live a whole life working, sowing, but they don't get afforded the chance to reap. So the field in which they've been working is basically filled with ripe fruits and vegetables all over the place that nobody ever picked. Because the person before you did all that work to produce all of that produce, and they didn't have the opportunity to reap that field. So now you come along, and if you can basically get advanced placement courses, you'll be in high school, you'll be higher education, you'll be in 400 level courses, you'll be in 800 level courses. And you're like, well, this is pretty easy. So you said, all I gotta do is get a tater sack and just get out there and start picking. I don't have to do any digging. I don't have to do any planting. I don't have to do any watering. He's like, well, why would we have you do that? So many people that come before you and did all that. We just need somebody to come and reap. You know, if you've ever heard about in the end, the reapers come, listen to a little Brad Jordan. He'll tell you all about the reapers. You start your journey into outer space. And the ones you love to love, they reflect on your mother's face. Something like that, because I'm not Brad Jordan. But it does put you in that vibe. So we highlighted a few people so far, Black history. And I really would love to honor Louis Black one day. But he's a white man. He's a Jew. But it is a little pun, a little play on words, because his last name is Black. And it was a beautiful day. I just love listening to Louis Black, you know, because he makes it all simple. But however, someone we've already highlighted in Black history, I reaped from their teachings yesterday. Floyd Money and Mayweather. Floyd Money and Mayweather, there was so many chicken wings all over the place last night. Rotel, meatballs, nachos, whatever people that look like me like to chow down on days like yesterday. It was all there. And I'm like, fruits and vegetables, fruits and vegetables, fruits and vegetables. So I did see a couple cherry tomatoes on the plate. On one of those big sandwich trays, I saw a few cherry tomatoes. All of the food on every tray was placed on top of some big leaf lettuce. So basically, I was having to pick up chicken wings and grab the big leaf lettuce from underneath the chicken wings. So they was a pretty good leaf lettuce because it was wrapped, it was kind of glazed in chicken wing sauce. You know what I'm saying? So sandwiches got a, you know, it was like the ones on the sandwich tray, it was like big leaf lettuce, breaded big leaf lettuce, you know, because it still had a little bit of that sandwich bread. So I might add that to my repertoire in terms of breaded big leaf lettuce and glazed big leaf lettuce if I ever had that itch, you know, for something a little bit more spicy or meaty or reminds me of another era. So yesterday, watching that MVP, Britt Reid, MVP of the Super Bowl, let his daddy down, went out there and it's been reported, almost killed a little child in Kansas City while driving impaired. Yeah. Nobody likes distractions during the Super Bowl. I don't know how big of a deal they're going to make it with a coach doing it, because I know when Barry Robbins from the Raiders took off to Mexico and the Super Bowl was 2 hours away, I don't think he made it to the Super Bowl that year. Big Barrett Robbins, offensive lineman for the Raiders a while ago. The last time the Buccaneers won a Super Bowl. Fact check it. Barrett Robbins, the last time the Buccaneers won a Super Bowl was an offensive guard for the Oakland Raiders maybe at the time. You know, Raiders, they change cities. So Raiders are awesome people. You know, they do what they want when they want. So who knows what city they were in at the time. But he basically had a bad night, wandered off the campground, woke up in Mexico, and missed the Super Bowl. And I can't hate on Barry Robbins. You know, I think they said he might have been suffering from some type of split personality, though. But hey, I just woke up in Mexico maybe 2 months ago. So I hope it's speedy recovery, because I'm still, I still have the tendency and the propensity to wake up in Mexico. Eugene Robinson of the Atlanta Falcons soliciting a prostitute basically the night before Super Bowl for the Atlanta Falcons. This is in the old Dirty Bird days. Oh, and that was a great dance. I think you bring down one hand, then you bring down the other hand, and then you start, you know, flapping, 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 Dirty Birds, baby. Yeah, he took the wrong night to fly. He took off about 24 hours too early when he solicited that prostitute. And they also lost. But the head coach of the Chiefs, his son is on the coach staff. And basically, he has a car wreck. And they say he was impaired with drugs. And I believe it's the same son who basically had a lot to do with Coach Reed not still being the coach at the Philadelphia Eagles, because he was basically an embarrassment to his family and the organization because of his drug problems. So daddy, you know, basically swept him up, cleaned him up, gave him a job, and he shows himself again to not really be very responsible for the opportunities allotted him through his father, and Chiefs lose. I didn't know that that was going to happen. I just knew Floyd Money Mayweather told me, if you're not at least betting a stack, you ain't betting. And he threw some money at the camera and he said, step your game up. And when I saw Tom Brady, if you look like me, then you might say the great white hope. But if you just looking and peering through time, you see a destined winner. And I saw plus 450 that the Buccaneers will win the Super Bowl. And that means you bet $100, you get $450. And I'm like, Nick Saban just won number 7. Talking about 7th national championship as a college coach. Tom Brady's got number 7 on the line. And somebody that makes odds is a ridiculous for letting me win $45,000. Ding, 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 ding. Because what did I do? I did MJG style. You know, I backed them down, crossed them over, posted them up, and slammed on some pimping. Yeah, I slammed up some pimping in the sporting book world last night by basically placing my first Floyd Money Mayweather bet, guys. Like I said, I'm reaping from other people's laborers. Floyd been mixing it in and out with the sports betting business for a while, you know, being posted up in Vegas. But I never been that kind of guy because I don't like to be seen in casinos. But I did find me a little baby, and let little baby go in there and place that bet for me with those 10 bands. And she just loved it, just holding those $100 bills. And I'm like, baby, don't you skim off the top. Just go in there and tell them, show them these odds, show them this bet, and show them the money. Jerry Maguire came back outside with my ticket. And I ain't gonna be like Floyd. I'm not gonna show you the billion, you know, the $100 million check. But just understand, 10,000 just turned to 45,000 in the twinkling of an eye because somebody's son let their daddy down. That's all that was. Now, we didn't know that that was gonna happen because, you know, the odds were Kansas City was a favorite. But there's a guard somewhere, Reverend Brown, coming to America. He told us. There's a guard somewhere. And and then there's a Malcolm X somewhere that the chickens came home to roost and it cost those Chiefs, but it benefited me. So I'm back in the Damon Wayans circle. More money, more money, more money, more money. What am I gonna do with it? Hey, I might be fiscally responsible. I just might put it up in one of those accounts and draw it out, you know, later on in life. You know, I may become one of those laborers and allow somebody else to reap from these, you know, measly 45 stacks later on in life. Because I don't need the money. Or, you know, I may just save it all for the Final Four and just paint the town in lamb's blood this April, on the first weekend of April. Maybe it be the men's Final Four. Maybe it be the women's Final Four. You know, maybe I'll just sit on them, because I am a baby fan. They thought I fell off. I'm just falling back. I got stacks in the wall for that. So options, options, options. Speaking of Reverend Brown coming to America, today's honoree, Black History honoree. He cold-blooded, you know, because I don't know if people understand. One thing about like Tom Brady, people like Tom Brady, and when they realize you'll never be Tom Brady. Yeah. Nino Brown style. I wasn't born with a silver spoon in my mouth, Miss Hawkins. Yeah. You know, so everybody can't be Tom Brady. Can't be born Northern California in the slums of the beat. Everybody can't be that guy. Everybody can be drafted late round with a stock cover and still be trusted. Get off to a great and early start. make the most of their opportunities and just stand in that pocket and just pick them apart. So when people see a Tom Brady type character, they're like, well, I'm not going to be Tom Brady because I wasn't born with a silver spoon in my mouth. And then they say, well, I'm not going to be Peyton Manning, who's going to stand in the pocket too and pick you apart, but going to work a lot harder to get there. But they say, oh, I'm not cerebral enough, or I don't have the work ethic to be a Peyton Manning. So then you start having all these offshoots of different kind of quarterbacks that say we can make it too. You know, like the Russell Wilsons and the Deshaun Watson and Mike Vick, you know, guys who go run around a little bit more and mix their natural talents with those traditional quarterback tangibles. But so this is our honoree for today. People knew way back when, we will never be Sidney Poitier. We will never be distinguished. We will never act right. We will never be able to play that part. You know, we ain't no Jackie Robinson. You know, this is Sidney Poitier like a Jackie Robinson. He was the first Black man to ever win an Academy Award, Best Actor, in 1964. So, you know, that was under the times of scrutiny and heat and shut your mouth and your fat.
I feel good.
Hopping Bob. So, these are in those days, and people knew, I can't be that guy. So they became other type of actors, you know, Blaxploitation, you know, being a little bit more cultural, being a little bit more ethnic, the way some of us say it, being a little bit more real. So they did establish their identities by basically not being Sidney Poitier. Same way a lot of quarterbacks and people in the professional sports, football, have established great identities by basically not being Tom Brady. Now, that doesn't mean you go get 7 Super Bowls, but you know, you might get put on enough to make you some money. But we already know the cream of the crop is Tom Brady. Just like in acting, in terms of Black people, the cream of the crop is Sidney Poitier. So you can adapt all these fancy philosophies and fancy ways of acting on that stage and get a lot of applause and get a lot of laughs. But at the end of the day, we know you're not what they were thinking about when they designed an actor. What they were thinking about when they designed an actor is not you. It's Sidney Poitier. So you can keep getting over with those flashes and dashes. But we all know you are not the genuine article. You are somebody who tried to modify the template to benefit you because you didn't want to put in the work to be what we were looking for. So you tried to force this new self upon us. And if you can look through the annals of time, because you might not know much about acting, yeah, but if you look through the annals of time, these quarterbacks that don't symbolize or don't resemble Tom Brady, they don't have 7 Super Bowls and they don't have multiple Super Bowls. It's those guys that get back there, stay in that pocket and rely on their teammates. Pass, 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 handoff, 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 pass. You know, getting other guys involved, not guys who running around like a chicken with their head cut off and they own teammates wondering, what is he going to do? There's not a lot of trust in those type of teams. So those type of teams don't really win that much. Same thing with Sidney Poitier. If you do it the way that Sidney said you got to do it, a Bahamian American who there's a guard somewhere who saw fit, that guarded somewhere, saw fit to make him a United States citizen by birth, even though he was from the Bahamas. You know, those same port authorities who allowed his mother to take a trip and visit Miami while super, super duper pregnant. And while she was in Miami for the weekend, you know, dropped Sidney Poitier on that American soil, you know, making him an automatic United States citizen and opening up the world to him, you know, from birth, born Tom Brady style. Everybody can be born with a silver spoon in their mouth, but Sidney Poitier, maybe not raised like Tom Brady in Northern California, San Mateo, but definitely born with a silver spoon in his mouth just by taking his mother, having that intuition to take that trip, you know, on the cusp of delivery, and then having that baby on that American soil, you know, opened up the world for him. And he went from acting to being an ambassador for the Bahamas to Japan. Wow. So that's two different islands. One island I can kick it out at all times, and which happens to be a British colony. The Bahamas is a Brit, you know, is a British colony, was a British colony, you know, Bahamas. It's basically where King George, I believe, the sixth, was basically banished with appointment to go be basically the governor of the Bahamas after he abdicated the throne, but right, basically didn't leave the royal family, so they had to find something to do. Like, yeah, we'll just send you to the Bahamas. So that's where, you know, City Poitier is from. Paradise. It's where kings go. It's where kings go when they're banished. You know, it's like King Joffrey Joffer. He said, take him to the Waldorf Astoria and bathe him thoroughly. And they started laughing and smiling. Yes, but that was supposed to be punishment. Same thing with King George, I believe, the sixth. You know, banish him to the Bahamas so he can learn his lesson. He's like, at once. So, you know, that's the situation Sidney Poitier found himself in at birth. A dual citizen. And, you know, Omega Jim and I have been searching about this dual citizenship. But we got to earn it. You know, we weren't born with that silver spoon in our mouth like Sidney Poitier in terms of just having that dual citizenship at birth. So big shout out to Sidney Poitier today. They got the job done. Now, can you remember who his not quite antagonist, but who his opposite was back in the day? And that's what I'm trying to say. You think you cold-blooded because you offer something different than what they're looking for. And you may enjoy a season, but if you do your history and you realize the character that they would put against Sidney Poitier to show that you don't have to be like Sidney Poitier, you can do different style and still get paid, that man was Bill Cosby. So that's what I'm trying to tell you. All you little quarterbacks out there just thinking y'all gonna get paid and shine. Yeah, you're gonna get paid and shine, but when they allow you to get paid without doing it the way it's supposed to be done, you start cutting corners in other parts of your life. Yeah. So learn how to drop back, learn how to read the defense, and learn how to pass the ball. Because if you start running around on that football field, you'll be running around in life. And I'm not gonna say you're gonna turn into a Bill Cosby, but I'm going to tell you right now, you're going to be finding other ways to get it done when the way has already been set. And I'm not going to go on a tangent about people with money that's manipulating other grown folks. But you will be a little bit more structured if you can more easily adapt to the established order. Because the established order, you really don't have to labor, especially in terms of sowing and planting. All you have to do is reap, because the way has already been paved. If you have any questions, comments, concerns, send them to Welcome to New York City. If you have any memes, videos, pictures, we got a funny one last night. With Andy Reid holding up his play sheet, but they gave us an inside scoop into his play sheet, and it was basically a Waffle House menu. That was funny. So if you have any memes, videos, pictures, I love LA. Send them to LA. Big shout out to Omega Jim, the producer, OG. Bright and early. And all the time, bright and early ain't good. Because if you didn't know, and I don't know if they still have it on those shelves, bright and early is not orange juice. So I don't know if they sell bright and early on the shelves of the grocers in your neck of the woods, but if they do, and the guy just got the box is orange, does not mean it's orange juice. Lay off that Tampico. That's what they have where I'm from. Tampico. Lay off that Tampico. Spend a couple more dollars. Find something with some pulp in it. Get that in your life. Hey, I'm in rare form. I'm like Michael Irvin last night. I'm in rare form, baby. Because Tunica gonna have to pay up this morning. I'm headed to Tunica, baby, because Vicksburg's just a little too close for me, you know. And the coast is out of the question. They got pirates down there. You know, they'll be waiting to claim your booty down there. And I ain't talking about your rock, you know, your prizes, your winnings. They real pirates in the coast. So they are already posted up in the precise alleyways to basically reap from your hard work. But this beautiful day, Sidney Poitier, a real classic. A real classic. We might have to play some Frank Sinatra to best suit Sidney Poitier. But nonetheless, a beautiful day like this definitely reminds me of a song.
That's why your mama told you that you couldn't go out. Stand up. Go sneak out tonight. He's gonna take by her window. Cause it sure wants to go.